Now for some spectacular waterfalls in the vicinity. The first is Lisbon, north of the village of Hrasco, at 92 meters, the highest fall in the area. One should stay well clear of the edge, as the rock face is very slippery, especially when wet. Next on our list is the Bridal Veil, a very apt name indeed. The waterfalls over a precipice of 70 meters and can be reached over a rather challenging 750 meter walk. Forest falls are the only ones that are wider than they are high. They're reached by an invigorating walk through a pine forest. Lone Creek Falls are also proclaimed a national monument, and they're near the village of Sabi, which is named for the river nearby. Also nearby is the Lone Creek River five-star boutique lodge. Of special interest are the 56-meter twin Macmac Falls. When gold was discovered in the stream above the falls, about 1,000 diggers staked their claims within a few months. Eventually, they dynamited the river at the falls to create a twin waterfall. A surfaced pathway takes visitors to a viewing platform above the falls. Next, we visit an extraordinary natural phenomenon with the awesome name of God's Window. Through this window, one can see sheer cliffs plunging more than 700 meters to the Lowveld, with its many game and nature reserves, which have made the region one of Africa's prime wildlife destinations. On a clear day, if it's possible, you can see the Lebombo Mountains in the far distance and the border of Mozambique. God's Window is located at the southern end of the Blada River Canyon. This deep scar on the face of the earth is 26 kilometers long and about 800 meters deep. It is the third largest canyon in the world, after the Grand Canyon in the United States and the Fish River Canyon in Namibia. Most prominent and unusual of the canyon sandstone formations are the three rondavels, huge circular outcrops which resemble real rondavels, the huts made by the local indigenous people. The route leading to the canyon starts at the village of Hrasgorp and includes God's Window, the Pinnacle, and Birkslut potholes. Like so many other towns in these parts, Hrasgorp originated as a mining camp in the 1880s. The gold mining days are long forgotten, and the town today is the commercial center for a large afforested area with several sawmills. Hrasgorp boasts a fine range of accommodation and activities, such as the big swing, quad trails, hiking, archery, and gold panning.